Hi, this is Eileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about analyzing simulation results in MagIX using a simulation module and modifying your build platform based on these results. The simulation module creates virtual prototypes of your parts so that you can visualize build risks. Based on this information, you can make the necessary modifications to increase build and part quality before actually building the part, and as such avoid wasting valuable time and money. The simulation module is easy to use, fast, and doesn't require simulation expertise. Moreover, you can run all your simulation related operations without even leaving MagIX. Here, we have a build platform that has already been simulated. If you would like to learn more about preparing a build platform, calibrating for simulation, and running a simulation, please see our tutorials on these topics. We'll go to the Job Manager to open our simulation results in MagIX. Let's select the simulation result, right-click, and select Open in MagIX. In the window that opens, you can choose to load all results for all layers or filter out some of them. For this time, let's load everything and move to MagIX. If you enable the creation of a compensated part during simulation, the STL file of this part will open automatically. If you'd like to learn more about compensated parts, please see our tutorial on running a simulation. If you forgot to enable compensated parts, you can just go to the mechanical simulation in the Job Manager and have it created. And here are our results. Let's open the simulation results page and start analyzing. From the type drop-down menu, you can visualize different types of simulation results, such as displacement or deformation, failure criteria, recoater risk of hitting your part, and shrink lines. Let's take a look at the shrink lines first. We'll quickly change to the color overlay to see the shrink lines more clearly. And here they are. With this input, I can choose to reconsider the orientation of my part, for example. Let's check out the recoater risk next and enable layer by layer view. We can use the bar below to visualize how the recoater risk builds throughout the build process. We can even enable a cross-sectional view. The orange-red region that we see here seems like it has a high risk of being hit by the recoater. From the failure criteria, we can determine if we can expect failure due to material properties. We did our simulation based on titanium, which is a brittle material, so we need to check for brittle material failure. The high risks at the points where the support connects to the platform are false positives. But for the rest, we need to take some measures. For the piece of supports here, for example, we might need to optimize the teeth. Let's go on with deformation or displacement. We can visualize deformation in a single direction or the total deformation. As it seems, the same region with higher recoater risk is also deforming the most. We can see from the range below that the deformation is around 0.55 millimeters, but we can use the probe to get a more accurate number. Now that it's confirmed that this region needs attention, let's go to the support generation mode to add some supports here. Because the color overlay is still visible in the support generation mode, we can see exactly which region we need to add support to. I'll just put some supports and generate them. Once we hide the simulation results, we can see the new support we generated, all based on the simulation results. As a final step, you can run another simulation on your part with the new supports. If all risks are eliminated, you can go ahead and print this part. In thermal simulation results, you will see the overheated regions, the temperature, and the peak temperature. Temperature represents the evolution of temperature during heating and cooling. Peak temperature refers to the highest temperature reached throughout this process. You can use this information to choose a suitable laser power or speed, or even recoating time. Overheated regions will have different properties compared to the rest of the part, and overheating can even lead to the material going above the boiling point. For each layer, you will observe three steps: heating, end of heating, and end of cool down, respectively. If the value on the scale is greater than 1, that region is overheated. You can improve the heat transfer and reduce risks for an overheated region by adding supports or reorientating the part. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.